Thomas was connected to the internet for 12 seconds, and he had seen everything. He'd seen the cats who couldn't spell. He'd heard of the arrow through the...
It is awesome.
Never out!
Spoke wisely for a lesser, offered Sarah their help, so long as she then helped them save their friends. He said that he too had wondered at the secrets of this world and would quite like a go on the wisdom fountain. That was okay. Sarah marveled at his foolishness, but accepted his help. Possibilities of the outer world. She had heard legends of a third dimension. Perhaps she'd encounter one of those curves the blind square had spoken of. Sarah sensed the presence of the fountain. Just one more portal to go, and then she would have the knowledge. And then escape. Thomas looked at the glowing beam. That list he'd been writing seemed pretty petty now. This was all knowledge, all of it, right in front of him. He was sorry Sarah couldn't step into it too. He could tell she felt the same way, from the shouting and the screaming. Thomas was connected to the internet for 12 seconds, and he had seen everything. He'd seen the cat who couldn't spell, he'd heard of the arrow through the knee. He felt there was probably a thing called cake, but that it was a lie. He knew what they had to do. He hoped the others would understand. They were just beyond the next portal. Trapped permanently from the moment the clouds ate them. He explained this to the others. It was impossible to gauge their reaction. After all, they were just rectangles.